Итак, сегодня мы говорим о частных пространствах, и
я
очень рада
speaking personal space about personal spaces, and I want to introduce our first guest speaker, Konstantin Skotnikov, and he's an artist from Novosibirsk. He's been working in our framework for quite a long while, and one of his most known projects is participation of the group Blue Noses or Sine Nase, but he also worked as a solo artist, and particularly well being a very strong protagonist of the contemporary in his town. He organized a space known as White Cube, of which he'll be telling us today, and he'll be assisted by Sasha Shostakov, one of the researchers from the research group of Grasov. Well, perhaps may I ask you to begin with just to tell us a little bit about the overall context and the situation where White Cube gallery had emerged, and what other artist initiatives were happening in Novosibirsk, private, you know, public, and so on. Well, real terms, well, hello, I'm Konstantin. True terms, well, there was quite a lot of initiatives. And by the way, in my short, you know, pre-word, I want to express how much I admire your project. Well, really, it's really impressive. Well, this huge work on catalogizing, I don't know, all the works you've been doing, but and our situation is such that we exist there pretty far away from cultural capitals of the country, and we happen to believe that we are somehow overlooked, forgotten, and it turned out, well, to be on the contrary, opposite situation, and we've been communicating with Alexander with great pleasure and recent releases. So it turned out that the initiatives and artists in Novosibirsk, those who in the late 80s and 90s got involved in contemporary art, they all were coming out from, mostly they were graduates of the Department of Architecture. Because we had, and we already have it today, the faculty of the Department of Architecture, which is now currently called the University of Architecture, Design and Art. But that, in those years, it was just a branch or department of the Engineering Institute of Construction Engineering. And under the influence of the Moscow paperwork architects headed by Yuri Avakumov, well, this movement was also caught up there in our place in Novosibirsk back in 94-95. So you see the roots probably in that time. But I think in today's context we don't need to go any deeper into the origins, but the main organizers came out of the paperwork architecture, which is like Mizin, Dmitry Gumnigin, and some other names as well. Well, thus, when the initiatives relevant to architecture somehow were just nullified, well, that was quite a depressive period of early 1990s, till the time when the branch of Nova Oxford New Society, it's just the initiative of George Soros' foundation, was opened in Novosibirsk. So the institution was inviting guests from Moscow and St. Petersburg, and also seconding our local people to Russia's capitals and also abroad. So we established new contacts, new connections new friendships, and one day, well, my wife had received a letter from Paolo Böttger asking her to meet an Austrian artist who is looking for inspiration far away in the Orient, in Siberia. And that was Lukas Pusch, my partner and one of the founders of White Cube Gallery in Novosibirsk. And Novosibirsk is spelled in Russian, but the first three letters in English. But that was exclusively initiative and idea of Lukas Pusch. For some reason, he likes this kind of bilingual, title, which probably gave him some special inspiration. But by that time, and that was year 2007, the group of the activity of Blue Noses group somehow went down, sort of diminished. And I mean, in terms of my cooperation with them, and I was involved in curating that time, curators' activity, and naturally, well, responded to the initiative of Lukas. He appeared personally there in 2005, even 2 years before the initiative. So for 3 years, we were kind of getting momentum, and then he saw. But he was, overly impressed by the Soviet garages. And I think it's quite a distinct ready-made objects. Well, I don't want to know the size of notorious fountain, but it seems to me that our garage is quite appropriate, quite in the right place. So the matter is that back in 2008, we started searching for garage, and we actual garage, for the cars. And we bought a garage in one local co-op with a pretty weird name of Khrushchev. So for 6,000 rubles, we bought this garage from Mr. Khrushchev, and when we were moving it, we discovered some remaining personal things, reminding us quite clearly that the owner of the garage had immigrated to Israel. So sooner somehow, by some strange weird turn of developments, well, the garage was amended by Zil 130 truck. So now you're already talking about the new Taisi project. No, not yet. That's all happening before, even on the eve of White Cube openings. Well, we opened it. Inauguration was on the August 22nd. On the screen you see the performance by Olga Taylor, and instead of a bottle of champagne, we split there a bottle of Stelichne, which you see Lukas Pusch is breaking on the corner of this garage building, just symbolic for happy journey. But please tell us about the exhibitions which took place in the White Cube Gallery, and especially interesting to hear about the art marathon Parnik or Greenhouse from October of 2007. Oh yes, so in August of 2008 the White Cube was opened. Lukas had left without any problem, back to his hometown of Vienna, and I stayed there on location as the sort of estate manager, and we started to arrange the exhibitions with a frequency of 1 to 2 weeks, trying to support the project, to keep it going, and giving just the exhibition space for young, maybe not so young artists who arranged one night, one evening exhibitions. Well, it was started by Barnaul artist Tatiana Abanina, then it was followed by Tatiana Bukova's exhibition, a photo artist. Well, her works are quite, in my opinion, very interesting, sort of metaphoric, and sometimes even kind of generate certain sick feeling. And by the way, the discoverer of the gallery was Konstantin Yeryomenko. I believe this artist is one of the leading figures in the Siberian new art, and he already exhibited his works here at Винзавод in Moscow, and he became quite a famous personality within narrow circles. And he had a very interesting project entitled The Ecstasy of Class Hatred. Yes, that was the title of the exhibition of the White Cube. But he had invented such a character, Siberian guerrilla fighter, separatist Lykov, who in his young years was a partisan or guerrilla fighter, but he just got fixed on his phases, and still he is fighting with all kind of, you know, weird creatures, you know, in the territory of the Russian Federation. So he's feeding up Chiburashka, notoriously from cartoons, and he's always amazed and surprised without not very happy and affluent life. So that was kind of caricature, humorous character. So the pinnacle of this activity was manifested by the project of Andrei Kurchenko and Ivan Dyrkin. Art Marathon Parnik, or the greenhouse, went from 11 till 11 at night, all day long for 12 hours. Every half hour or hour, the artists came up to the public and they were demonstrating the works. See, Irina Boldova is just fading fish, and the performance, well, was, she was blunting this fish, you know, head down, then they were floating up from this plot of little soil, heads up. Well, a very strange and very unusual young lady, in a broad sense of word. She's the graduate of our architecture academy. Yes, we are just pressed on time, for time a little. So please tell us about the events relevant to this appearance of Garage, your garage, and how the White Cube Gallery paid the visit to Ivan Dyrkin. She was hosted by Ivan Dyrkin. Well, the end of the story was kind of sad. Every morning I was going to work, on the way passing by the White Cube to check if everything is okay. On the way I met three policemen walking with the police doge, for some reason right next to the White Cube. And somehow the cleanest and neatest spot, which we really, you know, manicured and made it absolutely beautiful with Lucas, but somehow they were keeping close watch on me for some reason. And then on April 2009, everything came to the end when Artem Loskutov arranged, well, the exhibition entitled Monstration, if I got it right, 2009. Well, conceptual event, mostly, you know, there were just tablets with texts, but some texts were quite ironic and funny. one of them was, for example, saying that monstrance, well, which was just a short version or based on demonstrance, demonstrate, monstrators. So they had to walk up the main thoroughfare of the city, come up to the mayor's house, and by the collective willpower of their conceptual political outlooks, lift up, elevate the mayor's building in the air, then put on the bonfires, and then disperse. And also, then by the will of their hypnotic power, they had to put the building down. So the humor was not properly interpreted. It was interpreted in pretty direct way. So they want to lift up the mayor. So the authorities interpret as blasting the mayor's office. So everything was taken quite bluntly and without any second meaning. So Artyom was became the victim of harassment. Well, 25 days he spent in detention. Well, so as you see, well, 2009 year was quite a tragic year for me, frankly speaking. Well, very unnerving as a result. In summer, Lukas Push came to our town again. We loaded garage on the truck, and we started a new project, which we called A New Taiti, following just the steps of Paul Gauguin, Эмиль Польде, and Russian. I forgot Petrovich as well. So we went to the border of Mongolia, but we don't cross it. So here you see the village of Inya. We were also accompanied by Ivan Dyrkin and the photographer. So here we're having fun with Lukas Push in the Altai area. Then we went to Krasnoyarsk to the museum Biennale, where we got the prize for in the public art category. And then in 2012, after a long permanent exhibition on the plot of land belonging to Ivan Dyrkin, we moved westward and we got as far as Köln in Germany. So that was the end of our odyssey. Well, thank you very much for such a detailed and precise story of all your revelations. So at this, perhaps, we'll draw the final line after your presentation. Yes, in conclusion, just I want to say the following. I was permanently kidding, saying that all garage owners must become artists, and in every garage box a private gallery must be open. That was a joke in that time. And now what do we see in 2015? Yeah. You joke too much, as the side comment. Now we see this garage movement. Well, the young artists do it on permit all the time. They patent white, and that's what's being done by Alexei Eryumin, Konstantin Grishenko, and the third author. So at least we have already three new artists who arranged their personal solo exhibitions in garages, in garage boxes. Thank you.
Thank you, Konstantin. So we see garage inside garage. Actually, there is one initiative in St. Petersburg which is also inside garage building.